So you'd like to graph a polar equation with your graphing calculator. Well, this is what it's going to look like on a TI-Nspire, whether it's CAS or not. We're going to toggle between the scratch pad and go to the calculator. Nope, don't want the calculator. We're going to the graphing calculator portion. We're going to hit menu. We're going to go down and select 3 for graph and edit entry, and that's where you can tell it that I want to graph a polar equation. So we're going to be graphing in this a Limacon with an inner loop. And that equation is going to be 1 minus 3 times. And sometimes you can get away with not hitting that times button and just let it be assumed to be multiplication, but then other times the calculator doesn't like that. So 1 minus 3 cosine of theta. We're going to go for theta one place is to come down here where the pi symbol is, open up that window, arrow over to theta, select it, and of course, well, that is what we want to graph, 1 minus 3 cosine of theta. You can change the step of the graph here if you find that this is necessary. You can decrease the interval that theta is going to graph in, like say some graphs you can get away with, like if you're doing a rose with an odd number of petals, you could get away with this only going from 0 to 3.14, excuse me. And then some of the more complicated polar graphs, you actually want to extend that beyond 6.28 to get the entire graph. But this is going to be good for what we're dealing with. We're going to go ahead and hit enter. And there is our Limacon with an inner loop. But this calculator tutorial is actually part of a full-length lesson graphing polar equations. And we were interested in getting the values off of the table. So we're going to hit menu. We're going to go down to table. And I could have just hit 7. We're going to do it in a split screen, like right here. I'm going to hit the 1. Now, I have a table already set up, but I wanted to count by specifically pi over 12 radians, or effectively 15 degrees. So I'm going to go to menu. I'm going to go to table. We're going to edit it, the table setting. We're going to start that at 0, just for convenience. And we're going to count, I want to count by, again, pi over 12. So pi, enter, divide that by 12. And now we have the table of values starting at 0. And at 0 radians, we had a radius of negative 2. At pi over 12 radians, we had a radius of approximately negative 1.9. At 2 pi over 12, or pi over 6 radians, we have a radius of negative 1.6 approximately. At 3 pi over 12, or pi over 4, we have a radius of negative 1.12 approximately, and so on, counting down by increments of pi over 12, or every 15 degrees. Now, if once you're done getting the information off this table that you like, you can turn it off. Now, if you select the graph portion of your split screen and you hit menu, you might find it quite difficult to figure out how to get rid of that table. But if you select the table portion of your split screen, hit menu, go down to table, and you can remove it. And that is how you graph a polar equation with your Nspire calculator and create or look at that table of values if you need it. Now back to our full-length lesson, or if this is just the tutorial, the short tutorial you watched, thank you for watching.